In this video, I will show you how to upload and manage videos on your site using VideoPress. It is built right into WordPress.com, allowing you to host, customize, and analyze your videos all in one place. It works smoothly on all modern browsers and devices, ensuring excellent playback on screens of all sizes, from smartphones to desktops. Also, VideoPress is unbranded and ad-free. To get started, go to your WordPress dashboard and open the post or page where you want to add a video. Click the plus button top left and search for VideoPress, and then add the block. From here, you can either upload a new video directly from your computer or choose an existing video from your media library. Once the upload finishes, WordPress automatically processes and optimizes your video to play smoothly on any device. After your video is uploaded, you can customize the size and how it plays. When you select the video, you can use the block toolbar to change the alignment of the VideoPress block to full width or, for example, wide width. And you can also drag the handle of the video to adjust the player size. Furthermore, below playback in your sidebar settings on the right, you have multiple options. Autoplay allows you to start the video automatically when the page loads. And when you enable loop, the video will play repeatedly. And you can select mute if you want the video to start with no sound. Viewers can then unmute if they want to. Next, you will notice show controls is enabled by default, and this will ensure that the playback controls are displayed. For example, play, pause, volume, etc. Then you also have an option to play in line, which will allow the video to play in line on mobile devices instead of full screen. And then you will see preload metadata is also enabled by default. Next, below poster and preview, you can select a thumbnail or poster image for your video. You can also use the block toolbar instead if you wanted to. You even have the option to select a frame from your video if you prefer. So in this example, let's add a time frame and save our changes. And now the video has an updated thumbnail. And then lastly, you can also enable video preview on hover. When we make our way to privacy and rating, you can set an audience rating for your video and also choose to set it public, private, or use your site's default privacy setting. Below that, you also have two options. You can allow a video to be downloaded and also allow the video to be shared. This is enabled by default and gives viewers the option to share the video link and the HTML embed code. Let's take a look at it from the front end to view it as visitors would. When they start to watch a video and then pause it, they can click on the little arrow icon top right of the player and then share it with others. Please note, you can also adjust sharing and download settings for an individual video from your media library. You can use the filter to only view videos. And when you open a video, you will see the settings on the right. And you can click Edit More Details for additional options. Next, you can add chapters and captions to your videos to make them more engaging and accessible. Let's start with chapters. When you select a video, you can add timestamps below description in your sidebar settings on the right. Here are a few things to keep in mind. Make sure that the first timestamp starts at 0 minutes, and add a minimum of 3 chapter entries with at least 10 second intervals between each. And when you're done, remember to save your changes. To ensure a video has captions or subtitles, you need to add text tracks. To do that, click Text Tracks in the block toolbar, then you will need to upload your .vtt file, also known as your web video text tracks file. But you can also use the auto-generated text track if you prefer. Please note, there are many free tools available to generate one. So once you have created your .vtt file, you can export it to your computer. Then you can click Upload Track, select the track from your computer, and then you will need to add the label, the source language, and then select the kind of track, followed by saving our changes. And now, when you watch the video from the front end, you'll be able to see the various chapters And when you click Settings, you can enable captions. Next, VideoPress also gives you access to detailed video analytics. From your dashboard, make your way to Stats, and then scroll down to Videos. When you click View Details, you'll be able to see impressions, hours watched, retention rate, and views. Impressions refer to the number of times a video was loaded on the page. Hours watched is the total number of hours that the video has been watched by all viewers. And the retention rate is the percentage of a video's total duration that is watched on average per view. And lastly, views is the total number of times the video was played. You can also download a CSV file with the stats of all your videos. And that's it. With VideoPress, you can upload, customize, and manage videos right inside WordPress.com.